So given the decline in our rates, our hospitalization, strong vaccination rates, and the CDC guidance, my friends, the day has come. Today we are going to be announcing that we'll be lifting the statewide mask requirement in schools, and that'll be effective this Wednesday, March 2nd. So why are we waiting until March 2nd? This came out at the end of the day Friday. We took the entire weekend to work with our Department of Health and our team here at the Chamber, as well as reaching out to the teachers, the PTAs, talking to school superintendents, and even our Commissioner of Education, Betty Rosas, who's been so embedded in this issue with us, and what an amazing partner she has been. So we wanted to make sure that we had the advice and the wisdom of all these different groups that are really directly affected by this decision. And in touch with them for a number of days, they let us know that, yes, students are coming back, but a lot of families are still on vacation until later tonight. A lot of people work in the school system are not back, so they wanted a little bit of time to assess guidance that we are working on. It'll be out very shortly, again, in consultation with these school leaders. This is how we do it here in the state of New York. But we believe that by Wednesday, we'll be able to have a situation where we'll have the lifting of the mask requirement, and children, that includes children who are in child care centers ages 2 and up, who are covered right now. Now, this is an important point to make. We will lift the statewide requirement based on all the data that I've just outlined. However, there are some states, some counties in the state of New York where they have a higher rate of transmission. We will allow them the flexibility to determine what's best for their county. We would encourage them to take a look at this and follow the CDC, but this will no longer be a mandate. Not just the counties, though. We're leaving it up to the counties now. Also, this is up to parents. Individual parents have their own knowledge of their children. They know their own children's health. They know their tolerance for the mask. They know whether for them, if they've got an underlying health condition, that they would want to keep the mask on. But again, this is about what the parents now want to do beginning Wednesday with respect to their children's health. But I want to send a loud message that we will have no tolerance in our school system or anywhere for any harassment or bullying of any child or their parents, because social media is also a platform for bullying adults and children. They will not have any tolerance for people who are questioning someone's own personal decision to do what they want. If people want to continue wearing masks, they allow to continue wearing masks. And I don't want any issues related to that, and I want to be very clear on that. We will not stand for any bullying or ostracization or harassment of an individual or a business or anyone who chooses to wear a mask as we're still going through this.